Hey friends, we're continuing our .NET Core 101 video series. In our last video, we were kind of refactoring and restructuring our project, and you said that we should go and get some NuGet libraries. That's a funny word.
Yeah, NuGet is a funny word. NuGet is basically the package manager for .NET, and a package manager is any kind of collection of libraries that you can go and grab, install on your project, and those are all of the dependencies that your project has. So let's take a look at some of the libraries that we have available.
Mm-hmm. So NuGet is a whole ecosystem. I can actually go to NuGet, NuGet.org, mm-hmm. and look at how many packages are out there. There's hundreds of thousands of packages. They've been downloaded billions of times. And I can search for them. I can see, you know, statistically the ones that are the most popular. I can click on them, see if they're verified or not, and whether they're one that I want to get involved in. One of the packages that I thought would be fun is called Humanizer. There we go. And you can see it says 55 packages returned, because Humanizer is actually a whole series of packages. They've got a package for their main project, as well as different resources for different languages. But if I click on one of those, I can see how to install it using different techniques. I can see when the last time it was released. I can even click to go to the project site and learn about that project on GitHub, because it's open source, and see that this is a cool project that does the things I want it to do. In fact, Humanizer is really cool because it lets you display data types in friendly, human-y ways.
Oh, so right? Less so like a computer.
Yeah, it humanizes things. So instead of saying an actual time, I might want to go and humanize a date and have it say 2 hours ago.
Oh, or yesterday, okay.
Yeah, isn't that cool?
Yeah.
So I thought, since we're making a cool bank, that maybe we would want to humanize it. So I guess I could go and download it and find a zip file and unzip the zip file and code in my project. No?
Let's make that a little bit easier. Let's do it. Let's go and grab that package through Visual Studio.
Okay, so I'm back in Visual Studio. Let's play with it first. What do I do to get that NuGet package?
Yeah, so you can right-click on either your solution, or if you're only installing it on one project, you mm-hmm. can right-click on that project and go to Manage NuGet Packages.
Okay. Ah, so integrated into Visual Studio, I can go and browse all of those packages. So let's go and say Humanizer. There we go. So I'm going to go and pick Humanizer Core, because I'm just going to use English. If I picked the main Humanizer one, I would get all the other languages of the world that they support. But for the purposes of what we're doing, I'll get the simplest one. If I knew that there was a certain version I wanted, I could get that. But I'll just pick the latest stable version, if that's okay with you.
Oh, sounds good.
Okay, so I'll hit install. And it's going to say that I'm going to go and do that. And is that okay? Hit okay. Installing NuGet package. Completed. And then what happened?
So why don't we go ahead and expand our packages? See, so now we have humanizer.core installed on our MySuperBank project.
And this is really important to point out, because remember earlier in our previous video where we went and we added a reference to our Banky library, now we have another reference, except it's a package reference. We've brought in someone else's code. This is the first time we've used someone else's code in our project, and we brought in Humanizer. Okay, so we brought that in here in SuperBank because I thought it would be fun to play with it first before we decided to integrate it with our bank. So what I'm going to do for the purposes of this is I'll just make some room, and I figured we can just play up at the top, if that's okay.
Sounds good.
So we'll say console.writeline, and Humanizer is really cool. It's got a bunch of different features, and it's libraries like this, just as an example, that make the .NET community so great. Because, I mean, I could think about ways to write an app like this or a library like this, but I just want to make a bank. Right?
Oh, yeah. And I love when you realize you have a problem, but probably a lot of other people have had the same problem, and they might have developed their own solutions for it and shared them with you already. Mm-hmm. It's almost like you never think that you're alone in what you're coding and what you're trying to accomplish.
That's a great point. So here, if I say console.writeline car, that's just a string, right? I could print out car, and then check this out. If I hit dot, I get all the stringy things, right?
Right.
But we just brought in Humanizer, so let's go and say using Humanizer. So we're telling our system that Humanizer exists. I'll go back down to car, and look, this is really a little bit subtle. I'm going to zoom in here just as it faded away, and look at that. It's a method, but you see the little down arrow? It's a method that Humanizer added to all strings. It's an extension method. Pluralizer, swinging Humanizer, extended our strings. So we have new stuff that strings can do. Check this out. I can pluralize cars, or I can pluralize pant, or the ever controversial octopus. What is the plural of octopus?
Octopi.
I don't know.
Right?
Octo.
Am I wrong?
It could depend. It's going to be very controversial. Let's find out. I hit Control F5. Ah!
Octopi.
It is octopi.
Good.
Thank
you. I got nervous.
If it was octopuses, we'd have to just stop immediately and we'd put a pull request in to fix that.
Oh, yeah.
That
of
huge
course.
Problem. So that pluralized those worlds. So that's kind of cool. What else can we do? Well, this is one I thought that you would get a kick out of for a bank. Right line. Let's say that I could print out a number. Right? We know that we can do that. Numbers work great today. Okay, if I hit Control F5, we're just going to output 3501.
Okay.
Okay, check this out. This is a little more complicated. Two words.
Ooh.
Yes.
So is this going to like write it out?
Yeah, check this out.
3,501. How about that?
How cool is that?
Cool.
I could do that, but I don't want to do that. Think about the effort involved.
Like, I know.
It could be huge, right? And I just want to make a bank. So what do you say we make this print out words instead of amounts? Because that's silly.
Yeah, sounds fine. Let's be silly.
All right. So now we know how to do that. Now, this is interesting. Because I did that work over here in Maine, but I moved our libraries. Really, we don't want Humanizer down here, do we? We actually want it somewhere else. So I can go and remove that package just like that. I can instead go back up here and we'll have Humanizer exist up at this level. Humanizer. So Humanizer is going to be installed only at the Banky Stuff library. So we're making a dependency tree, aren't we? So Banky Stuff library knows about Humanizer, but my superbank only knows about Banky Stuff library.
Yeah, can so you remove that dependency?
A to B to C, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So where did we output all of our stuff? We did it in get account history.
Right.
So this is interesting. We have item.amount, and I think we put that on transaction, didn't we? Amount.
Right.
What about this? Public string amount for humans, right?
Right.
And then we could get that. We don't want to make a new string though, right? I don't want to do that work. Why don't we go and get that string from where we already had, which was in amount, and then we would say what? What was it?
It was
two words. Okay, but two words is not available right now because we need to tell it about the using Humanizer statement. So then it will go and get that. Okay. Well, let's see who's mad at me now, right? What is it saying here?
So
not
I think
all
we need
code
a return.
Pass. Yeah, so I just said amount two words, but I never returned it. So thank you for that.
Right, and it's expecting a string. Okay.
Yeah. There you go. So amount.
It still doesn't like amount.
And it's saying, hey, amount to words, it doesn't know how to do that. So we just learned something about the Humanizer library.
Right.
It knows how to do that for decimals, and it wants ints.
Hmm.
So it can say 1,000, but it can't say 1,000 point whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a couple of things that we could do
you
there.
You know, I was about to comment. When I was in sixth grade, they taught me in school that when you put and, that's what separates it between like 3,000, 1, and 1 cent. Is like where you add that, but that's not the way this library was written.
Well, there's a couple of ways
so
we can do that,
know.
Right?
Yeah.
So we can do what we learned in the C-sharp class where we did modulo, and we can go and get just the remainder and this and that.
Oh,
we can
yeah.
chop off things.
What if I don't really care about the decimals anyway?
Right.
I could
if I don't care, I could be aggressive.
Ooh.
Right? This is probably not
Got
something you want to do.
Forced cast.
So
makes me nervous.
What do you think? Is that that's wanting to do it? So here we have a decimal that has lots of information.
Mm-hmm.
We learned about that in our C-sharp video. I could shove it into a tiny box.
Mm-hmm.
But what happens when you take big things and shove them into tiny boxes? they crumple.
Doesn't always work.
And then you know when the package right. arrives, it's a mess. I don't know what'll happen there, right. but it might be interesting to see. It'll probably break something because any big number is going to get squished into that. Chaos might ensue.
I was hoping it'll work for our purposes, but that's just because we haven't really added all of the tests that we need to kind of
that's a good
stretch
point.
That capability.
We'll probably break this when we get to testing.
Yeah.
So amount for humans.
There we go. Right?
And then the tabs are probably going to get goofy as well. Let's see what happens. Okay, so this is interesting, and this will happen to people.
Yeah.
Yeah, so notice that I'm working over in Banky Stuff Library, and I hit Control F5, or I pressed Debug.
As one
and it's
does.
Like, yeah, because it's felt comfortable. It says, you can't start this directly. See how this is boldface, but if I click here, now that's boldface. The one that I'm currently clicked on is the one that we're going to start on. And I can go and right-click and force that as the startup project.
Yeah.
So I really need my program to be the starting project.
Yeah, let's keep our console as the startup.
So Control. Ooh, that actually kind of worked kind of cool. 10,000 minus 50. I didn't know it was going to put the minus there. There's a nice one.
Oh, right, because we had negative numbers when we were doing withdrawals.
Right.
Okay.
So those are the kind of things where we would want to decide when we write our specification, which we never really did for our bank.
Right.
Maybe we want it to say minus. Maybe we want it to say negative.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we would remove the word minus because we only want our the amount listed and not the negative.
And we'd add a separate column that calls out whether or not it's a withdrawal or deposit. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of different ways we could do it.
Yeah. But that was enabled in very short notice by just bringing in a NuGet package. There's so much great stuff that we can go and do. And at some point, we need to test this because I'm starting to feel a little nervous. Our app is getting complicated, and I don't even know if these numbers add up.
Right. So how about in the next video, we go over unit testing in Visual Studio?
Let's do it.